Hello and welcome back to Rock Bottom.
Hey yo. We just burned a brandy Bronson Bronson Bush.
We burned George Bush.
George Bush, Jesus.
Senior, don't worry about it.
Oh, senior, okay, that's Kate, that's Kato.
Yeah.
I mean, he would make for some good Tinder.
Yeah, he's dry as fuck.
he's real dried up.
A note scrawled by a tortured soul. The melody it plays on and will not stop. It's the root sandstorm. It's really terrible. The voice sings of pain and loss. These things I know too well, but still can bear. It is when the voice sings of hope that I learn true anguish, a longing for that which I can never have. Dude.
Yeah, that is the root sandstorm.
Who left their fucking like high school emo poetry on the floor here?
You bet on that sick ass mixtape.
Yeah, you might even say it's fire.
Man, it was sad.
I didn't do anything, I just pressed one button.
You are a bully.
You're a bully, go away. Oh, it's just this. Oh, great. Free
collect. Sticks and stones may break my bones, and so will it just never.
Free collectibles in this game.
Free?
Yes.
Minotaur horn, phoenix feather, and...
Gorgonite. We fall again, we fall again.
I mean, you gotta have some sort of entertainment in Hades, right?
I mean, I guess.
The fuck? Is this Harpies?
You can't have Deathflix.
Deathflix. Oh, fuck me and fuck you.
I'm sorry.
Did you make that up or did you steal it?
I just made it up on the spot.
Oh, god damn it.
Can you believe that?
I cannot believe that.
It sounds like I stole it.
Oh.
That's too brilliant.
Yeah, it's like, did you steal that?
I don't blame you for thinking I stole that.
Well, oh. I'm impressed. I'm impressed.
Thanks, man.
Fucking Netflix. Why is not a Netflix series called Netflix?
Netflix. There's a Death Note, and it's bad.
Yep.
And Willem Dafoe is totally underused.
But it's hilariously bad.
It's not even that, honestly.
Okay, what Daniel tries to like describe the movie.
When Daniel tries to describe it.
Minute for minute.
It's hilarious. Yes.
It's fucking hilarious.
Yes, and then I watched and I was like, okay, I see.
Okay, you went that far.
I see which, yeah, I have watched it.
Oh, you have watched it? Okay.
Yeah, like. And yeah, I saw it and I was like, okay, it's pretty bad.
I saw the trailer, I knew it existed, and that's as far as I got.
Yeah, I was... Oh man, that movie is so bad. It's like they saw the source material and was like, oh, it's about a book that kills people.
that's as far as I got.
And
then fuck the rest.
And left it at that, okay, yeah, so the cat and mouse detective game...
Come on, you can do it, you're a big boy. Come on.
get up against the wall and spread.
Get down on it.
Get up on the wall. Yeah. Get up against the wall and spread them. But officer, these blades were given to me by Athena. No, come on.
Dude, game, please. Did you see that? There's like a flash cut of an undead something skeleton jumping and it's just caught the frame.
Yeah.
Really, really close.
Yeah. They fall.
That's man, they and we were talking so much hype about this game.
Oh, I thought there was a secondary ledge.
I thought there was a cutscene to jump down for the ledge.
Oh, man.
Fuck me.
Oh, man, we're straight back into my favorite part, the fucking ledge.
The biggest challenge. Oh, my God.
I'm not hamming this up. I'm not.
Oh, okay, there?
See, I thought that was
yeah.
I was supposed to get
to.
There isn't. Spoiler alert.
The second ledge is a lie.
Game theory.
Did you know?
There is no secondary ledge.
There's only ledge. Fucking hell.
In Hades, you can become a legend. See, I immediately thought that I could jump up to the next ledge as well. You have to go. Okay, you just go across where there's nothing. Fine.
Yeah.
I haven't played fucking at least a half an hour of Uncharted for this shit. Now I can get up there.
Of course you can.
Fuck, man. I don't know if I've ever talked about this, but we recorded some Uncharted on the channel, of course, way back when it came out with Frederick. And it wasn't a greatest series because it was just a bad game and like it didn't give us much to deal with. But I went back and finished it by myself, just, you know, privately. Mm-hmm. And goddamn, I have rarely been as mad at a game as I was at that game. It's just...
Uncharted 4?
Yeah, Uncharted 4.
Yeah.
I was so close to making, like, a rant video about, oh, okay, I have to crawl on the ceiling, fine. I was so close to making a rant video about it because I was just so mad at how bad it was. And like, it just makes so many fucking design choices that are so just bad.
Have you played any of the other Uncharted games?
Yeah, I love Uncharted 2.
That's the big one.
Uncharted 2 is great and I want to play it on the channel as well at some point. I played Uncharted 3 as well and I did not like it as much.
No, exactly. I played Uncharted 2 like at a friend's place, so that's only half. But then I saw Daniel and his roommate back in the day play 3.
Uncharted 3.
And then 4. I've been talking so much with Daniel about 4. And it just sounds bad, dude. Wow, I thought you stuck that one.
4 is... Like, it was hard to finish.
Yeah.
And that's
a struggle. Yeah.
And that's a problem because there were sections that were okay. It's the gliding that I have problems with because I keep thinking I'm supposed to double jump and then hold it.
No, nope.
It doesn't work like that. No,
just hope.
Yeah, but like
we are learning, people.
there are parts of there are real okay. There
oh we go. Boy,
there are really neat parts of
just like a happy dinosaur. The shadow.
Oh, the shadow. Like the parts when you're in the car in Uncharted 4 and you're just driving through like open spaces and shit, and like they have conversations that are really organic and cool, and if you exit the car and go look at something and you get back in the car, they pick it up.
Yeah.
Those moments are super cool and I really like it for that. But like, it takes so long to get started. It has those really, really dumb sections where it presents a puzzle to you, and then, but you can't solve it until Sam, the brother character, just randomly says, oh, look here. And then he wipes a layer of snow off of something.
Oh, fuck off.
Dude. Yeah. So like, there was no way that you could ever solve the puzzle that you have been presented.
Because puzzles are a part of Uncharted.
Yeah.
100%.
And sure,
but that is just dumb.
Sure, I'm sure.
That's dumb.
Sure, if you go back and look at our playthrough, there are puzzles that we fail because we misunderstand the premise. Mm-hmm. That's one thing. Misunderstanding the premise of a puzzle is one thing. Actually, you know, trying to solve a puzzle and then it just arbitrarily saying, okay, here's a character who then says something. It's like
Yeah, so now you can solve the puzzle. Now.
That's really annoying. That's not a puzzle.
That's not a puzzle, no.
A puzzle you need
to
have...
That's a timed event where you're like...
Yeah, exactly.
What the fuck do I do?
We just ran around a cemetery and we're like, there's none of these... Like, we were looking for a specific... We were looking for a specific marker on a tombstone.
Oh, right, I remember that. Yeah,
we're looking for a specific marker on a tombstone. Or like a specific combination of markers on a tombstone.
Some kind of pirate or
whatever. Yeah, but they were nowhere to be found until Sam said, hey, look over here. And then he wiped a layer of snow off and was like, are you kidding me?
That was so dumb. I remember that part, yeah.
Yeah.
It's like, why ever give the player a choice to find something?
Yeah, exactly.
When... you're unable to solve the puzzle.
And there was another...
That's so dumb.
There was another part that really pissed me off, which was, there are these mummies later on with like explosives in them, and it says that they trigger with movement. So I'm thinking, okay, I have to sneak by them.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
But you're supposed to just gun it through them.
Of course, because it's fucking Uncharted 4.
You're supposed to just gun it through them, but it's like, what? And sometimes, even when you gun it through them, they just blow up in your face. So it seems totally random and arbitrary, and you're just like, but what? What?
Yeah, yeah. The mechanics are unclear.
And one thing
and the game is telling you one thing, and you try that one thing, and it doesn't work at all.
One thing that I really, really disliked, which was a going thing. Why do those condemned souls of Hades continue to seek salvation when they are eternally damned? You have the two extra climbing mechanics in Uncharted 4, which is the grappling hook and the grappling hook and the spike, right?
Mm.
So the grappling hook only works at designated spots. Yeah, I see it.
He's going.
At designated spots that are shit. Designated spots and only when a prompt shows up, right?
Yeah.
That's when the grappling hook works. That bothers me to no end because it's like you can see, okay, there is a grappling point there, and I want to grapple it, right? But you can't do it until there's a prompt. Thank you. You can't do it until there's a prompt, which is a problem, because especially in the high speed, like sliding zones.
Yeah.
When you're sliding and you have to jump and there's a grappling point, you're like, okay, I see the grappling point, I'm going for the grappling point.
Let's go.
But you can't do it until it shows the prompt for it. It's like, that's fucking dumb.
Mm.
And it's like that all the time. You can go through entire sections, no problem. And then you get stuck on something because there's no place to climb. And also because like the open areas are just too big in Uncharted 4, so you just walk around like a giant area. You're not really sure where to go and how to get there. So like the initiation climb is like on the other side of the map to the point where you're supposed to go, and you're just sort of supposed to like feel it out. And then sometimes there,
yeah, and then feeling it out is so hard though in some places.
Exactly, but like that's always been Uncharted. You're supposed to climb what's climbable, and that's fine, right? But then, one thing is climbing was climbable because that makes you go through trial and error. Another thing is when you have an arbitrary thing that doesn't work until there's a prompt for you to do it.
Yeah.
So you can sit in a section and have been totally fine until there's a prompt for you to grapple something, but it doesn't work unless you're in the right spot. So you're just like, ah, yeah. Oh, fuck, it was the fucking grappling hook, right? Then much later on, it introduces this other mechanic, which is like the spike. It's a climbing spike that works on specific pieces of wall. It works on specific pieces of wall, which you can see, they have a visual marker, they're porous.
Mm-hmm.
And then you have a button that always makes him take out the spike.
Yeah.
So you can at any time attempt the spike at anything,
but it won't work
unless you're at the designated spot, right? So that to me is a much more compelling mechanic, because you have a visual marker, you have a button that always does a certain thing, and those two things work in tandem, right? And
yeah. And
to me that's like, that works better than if you have a thing that only works at a certain spot and can only be done in context with that, with a prompt. That's a worse mechanic.
I got, like a few months back, I played a game with like Aloy.
The
machine Horizon Zero Dawn. Yeah. And they did climbing really fucking well.
Yeah, I've heard
so
much.
They made like obvious markers. You can grab this ledge and it ledge ends here,
but like,
or starts here,
but
everything is part of the environment.
Yeah, in gameplay, like environmental markers. Yeah.
It was super obvious, but it was not super obvious from like, here's a red marker, you can only climb or go to here, bang. Yeah. No, they made it part of the world, but really obvious.
Yeah.
So it was not like immersion breaking at all.
No, But that was my point with the grapple markers in Uncharted 4, because you could see the marker, you could stand before the marker, and like,
yeah, and you can recognize the marker, and you like
all the branches that you can grapple all look the same.
Yeah,
but
exactly.
But it's like, but unless you're standing in the right spot and like you're at the right point, it doesn't work.
Mm.
Like you can't just throw your grappling hook arbitrarily, which you can do with the spike. The spike you can attempt it at any surface, but it just won't work because that's not how that works.
Wow, that's dope though. You fucking took the Minotaur into stone.
I got a Minotaur.
Wow,
that's optimal gameplay.
Hey, we're speedrunning now, dude.
No, we're not. We would be done by the game if we were speedrunning.
I believe you do.
I need more mana.
You must construct additional pylons.
Oh, you know what I've been playing in WoW lately?
What have you been playing WoW?
I've been playing a rogue in WoW lately.
The fuck is a rogue?
I've never had a...
Oh, right, it's the second most played character I ever played.
Yeah, I've never had a max level rogue before. It's really fun.
Yeah.
Of course, they made a lot of rogue changes since you played. Obviously.
When was the last time I played?
You played in Pandaria last.
Yeah, but there's only the start of Pandaria.
No, end of Pandaria.
End of Pandaria?
Yeah,
we
played in end of Pandaria.
Fuck me, man.
Yeah. But yeah.
But rogues were already re-changed in Pandaria.
Oh, but they've been changed more.
Okay, of course.
Like one whole spec is completely changed.
Okay.
Fair. Like combat has been changed to outlaw now.
Okay.
And it's based around like the pirate side of being a rogue.
Ah, okay.
Which is, it was all like the combat.
Man, what, Blizzard is pushing pirates.
Yeah, but
big
like
time.
But combat was always the like the swashbuckling type.
Yeah. So it makes sense to make it a pirate.
Yes.
Yeah, I get that.
So you're doing swords, you're doing hidden pistols and grappling hooks and shit, and
hidden pistol. I ain't mad at that. That's
no, it's pretty cool. Like outlaw is pretty cool, and like with the artifact system, you have like the outlaw artifact is like a pair of cursed cutlasses that eat away at your life, but every when you activate an ability, every attack you do fills your combo points.
Okay.
But it drains 5% of your life with every finishing move you do.
So that's a
risk reward
system. Yeah.
Yeah. But they're pretty cool like that. But I don't play that. I play subtlety. Because subtlety is the best thing.
Subtlety used to be a problem.
Yeah, but they really blurred the lines with that, and like.
What was the last one? Sinister. No, that was a skill called Sinister Strike.
Sinister Strike, yeah.
What was this third
oh yeah,
tree?
I need to. Assassination.
Assassination.
Combat and subtlety.
Yeah. Assassination was the rage spec. Then combat was whatever, PvE,
yeah.
Casual.
Yeah, okay.
Something.
Yeah,
and subtlety was PvP.
The leveling spec.
Yeah.
Yeah. But they really mixed it up now where you have Minos, Aeacus and Radamantis. Yeah, those are the three judges. The judge the souls of the dead.
Those are the guys holding some kind of chain, though.
Yeah. They've changed it up so that every spec is viable for everything. It's done so that you have...
you don't have trees anymore, do you?
You don't have trees anymore, but the thing is that you have a dedicated PvP tree, in a sense. So you gain specialized PvP talents. So
okay.
So that you don't have cookie cutter builds for PvE or for PvP, so that you have an entire set of talents for PvE that you can choose from, and then you have an entire set of talents for PvP as well. So you have all the PvE talents for PvP, and then you have another set of talents for PvP.
So, I wouldn't say complicated, but
it's not
excessive.
It's not really. And it's like it's giving you stuff that isn't balanced for PvP for PvE in PvP.
Yeah, I get it.
So for instance, on my mage, I can get like a greater pyroblast that does like it does 30% of an enemy's health. That is not balanced in PvE, for instance.
No.
No. Because then I can just do 30 million damage on a raid boss.
Hey, got him.
Yeah, it's like. That's not cool.
I've been so far out of woe, man.
Yeah.
I've been thinking about getting back, but then now there's new expansion dropping in like soonish and
yeah, summer they say.
Yeah, and
I'm pretty.
And then I'm gonna be like two full expansions behind. And,
yeah.
And then a new one is like, oh my god, man, fuck, and I don't have time to play MMO anymore.
No, but when you do buy the new expansion, you get a free boost.
Yeah, but then I'm gonna lose all the old shit. I wanna experience the content. I know. You and Jesper been talking about Legion not being that.
Legion is
super good.
No, no, the other way around. Legion has been the best one in a while.
What was the one before? Oh, Draenor.
Draenor. Warlords of Draenor was ass.
Yeah. That was the one. Yeah.
That was ass. Yeah. That was not cool.
Yeah.
It was too like there was basically no content in it. It was,
yeah, Legion's one is now.
It's just like a grind and it was terrible. Legion right now is actually really good.
So as a prior, Walls of Draenor was fucking here.
Yeah, Walls of Draenor was not awesome.
Yep. I think you have to shoot it with your fire bow.
Yes, but where do I shoot it?
I have no fucking idea.
Is the issue.
You got maybe.
There is the swirly part here, but that's a different power, isn't it?
No, that's the hit of some of the justice in.
No, but like the swirly thing here in the air, I do something with a power.
Oh yeah, you get a lantern or something, don't you?
Yeah, I do believe I do.
Or is this the hit of Hermes?
Helios.
Huh?
I guess something anyway. Well, we'll figure this out and we'll come back to you next time on Rock Bottom. See you then.
Bye.